got Winston Peters with me, who just said that the world has gone mad. It probably has in his world. He's been trespassed from Parliament. Anyway, it is 24 minutes to 8. And earlier on the show, National Leader Christopher Luxon told Maddie he thinks the Speaker is overreaching by trespassing former MPs from Parliament after they attended anti-mandate protests earlier this year. Those MPs are former National Party member Matt King and former Deputy Prime Minister and New Zealand First Leader Winston Peters, who joins me in the studio this morning. Morning to Mr. Peters. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. You keep checking your watch. You've obviously got lots to do today. So let's kick into it. So what is the big issue for you specifically?
Well, the big issue is that the right to protest is fundamental to any democracy. And if you take that away, you get the kind of thing you see in countries that no one wants to live in, or if they live there, they do their best to get out of there as fast as they can. And so this fundamental freedom is now being truncated or taken away by the Speaker, who doesn't seem to understand the law of trespass that was passed in 1980, and I was in Parliament in 1980 when it was passed and he wasn't, or what the application should be, or a very famous case called Police and Begs in 1999, where a number of Labor people were the beneficiary of the court finding in their favour about being improperly trespassed off Parliament.
So he is the landlord, right? So isn't this part of his powers within Parliament?
Well, I'm just saying to you that we're going to go to court and prove, I believe, that it's not part of his powers. He said yesterday to a question in Parliament or an issue in Parliament, my powers are pretty much absolute. That's what he said. My powers are pretty much absolute. No, they're not, Mr. Speaker. You are constrained like every one of us by the law of this country, and you're going to have to abide by it. And when you use the trespass law, you must use it properly.
Is this about the law, or is this about Mr. Mallard?
Well, at the moment, I don't know why you're asking that question, because whatever the impact is, a whole lot of people who had their businesses and their lives utterly ruined, businessmen and women and workers, many of them were not violent. That was a real minority. Many of them are not criminal. They wanted to be heard by Parliament. And tragically, the parliamentarians met all the sitting MPs and said, we won't talk to them. Mm-hmm. This is unbelievable. I can't conceive of it happening in any other democracy. So when someone went down and said, at their request, I will hear you out, I'll listen to you, the Speaker has the audacity to trespass that person who hasn't broken any law at all, is not part of the protest, is just being an observer, listening to what they've got to say, has the audacity to trespass that person off Parliament for the next 2 years.
So you're telling me then that this isn't about you being a former MP and being trespassed?
Mr. Luxon's wrong, you see. He says there should be a distinction for members, former MPs and the public. No, there shouldn't be. Doesn't he understand the secret of the law is it should apply equally to the highest to the lowest? It should be one law for everybody. And that's another fundamental principle of a decent democracy.
So then, you're seeking legal counsel at this point in time, is that right?
Yeah, I've engaged legal counsel and we're off and running.
Yeah, okay. So what are you hoping to achieve as a result of this?
I want the law of this land upheld and not have these autocratic, despotic, tyrannical types of decisions that the Speaker has been making. You recall he said that there was a sex offender, a rapist in Parliament, a male. Every MP at that time and every male worker in Parliament was now being defamed. And then,
so then is this about Mallard? Or is this about
but I'm just saying, but what did the media say at that time? So it ends up, somebody sues him, it costs well over $300,000 in damage alone, plus the legal costs, all of which were at the cost of the taxpayer, and he still kept his job. How can you go on doing that? But I'm saying the laws of this country should be upheld equally, no matter who you are, no matter what your background is. And I think it's a principle worth fighting for, and New Zealanders should fight for it, because if they don't, then they'll find a decay in their society and an erosion of their fundamental rights as human beings.
Why were you there? As a former MP, why did you feel the need?
Because they asked me to. Thousands of people texted me, wrote to me. I got all the evidence of that. Went public and said, Winston Peters, will you come down and talk to us? And in the end, I decided. But I talked to a business couple one night, and they'd put everything into the business, a massively successful business, and they'd lost everything of 35 years of work. And I made up my mind, somebody's got to have to listen to these people because they're not getting a fair go.
You've got the ear of the people. So I'm thinking about Tauranga. the by-election is coming up next month.
Look, I think the trespass laws in this country and the way they're being wrongfully imposed by the Speaker is the issue of this conversation, as you all knew when you asked me to come here today. So,
Mr. Peters!
Let's not have a Trevor Mallard diversion and lose the plot.
No. I think you've made your point. But what my last question is to you, throwing your hat in the ring?
Let's not behave like Trevor. No, let's not behave like Trevor Mallard. And you know the sporting
term. Stop it!
And move the goalpost in the middle of the discussion or the middle of the game. That's not how the game's played.
So,
thank you very much. And you have a marvellous day.
You are a wicked, wicked man. So you're not going to answer.
You have a marvellous day, I should say. You're not going to detour me. This is a principle worth fighting for, and it's going to cost a lot of money. Just get that clear. But I'm saying to my New Zealand public, look, now's the time to stand up right here, right now. You can't take any more erosion of your rights anymore.
Mr. Peters told me before this interview, I'm not telling you the answer to that question. Anyway, well, as always...
Yeah, you're slow learning. You don't get it.
As always, it's lovely to have you here with us on Breakfast, Mr. Peters. Thank you.